So the purpose of this webinar is to provide an overview of Ontario Power Generation's Darlington project and provide information to answer questions such as who is the CNSC and what does the CNSC do? Also, what is the Darlington New Nuclear Project? What is the license review process? And how are Indigenous nations and communities and the public involved? Next slide, please. So we'll first begin with an overview of the Canadian Nuclear Safety Commission and where I'll explain who we are and what we do. Next slide, thank you. So the CNSC is an evidence-based regulator. We use laws and regulations to protect, prevent unreasonable risk to the environment, to the health and safety of Canadians, and national security. The CNSC was originally called the Atomic Energy Control Board, which was created in 1946 and became the CNSC in the year 2000. Now our mandate is described in the Nuclear Security Control Act, which is the main legislation that we use to regulate, and it basically describes what the CNSC is responsible for. And the CNSC is the only authority in Canada that regulates nuclear energy, nuclear substances, and other nuclear equipment and information. Essentially, the CNSC has a mandate which includes three main objectives. The first is to regulate the use of nuclear energy and materials to protect the health and safety and security environment in Canada. The second is to implement Canada's international commitments on the peaceful use of nuclear energy. And the third is to communicate information to the public and Indigenous nations and communities. And we don't promote nuclear activities, but it is the CNSC's job to safely regulate these activities. Next slide, please. Now, the CNSC regulates or provides oversight for all nuclear-related activities in Canada, as shown here on the slide. Now, the CNSC is responsible for overseeing the mining of uranium, the transportation of radioactive materials, the production of medical isotopes, the manufacturing of uranium fuel bundles that are used in Canada's nuclear power plants, and of course, nuclear power plants and nuclear waste. This also includes small modular reactors. Now, the CNSC has issued something in the order of 2,000 licenses for activities ranging from the administration of nuclear medicines to the operation of nuclear power plants. Next slide, please. The Commission. Now, the Commission is an independent, quasi-judicial administrative tribunal that is arm's length from the government. Now, an important characteristic of the Commission is that unlike most government departments or agencies, they do not report to a minister. Rather, the CNSC Commission reports directly to Parliament through the Minister of Natural Resources. It is an important distinction and increases the independence of the Commission. Now, as you'll notice on this slide, the Commission is composed of up to 7 permanent Commission members by Governor and Council based on their qualifications and expertise. As for Commission proceedings, they are open to everyone and webcast live. Any input from Indigenous peoples, the public, and stakeholders are always welcome. Now, all Commission decisions are transparent and based on the information received before hearings provided by the proponent, CNSC staff, and intervener. And the record of proceedings includes detailed reasons on why a license or is granted or is not granted and is available on the CNSC website. Next slide, please. Now, this slide shows the locations of the CNSC offices in Canada. We have staff located across the country. Of course, the headquarters is located in Ottawa. Now, there are site offices in each of the nuclear power plants. The office of the Uranium Mines and Mines Divisions is located in Saskatoon. And I'd like to note that Saskatchewan is the only province with operating uranium mines and mills. Next slide, please. Now, as a regulator, I'm responsible for establishing a licensing and compliance system to ensure that all persons who use or possess nuclear substances and radiation devices do so in accordance with a license, and that regulated parties have safety and security provisions in place that ensure compliance with regulatory requirements. Now, this ensures that licensees are directly responsible for managing regulated activities in a manner that protects health, safety, security, and the environment, and that conforms with Canada's domestic and international obligations on the peaceful use of nuclear energy. Through this licensing and compliance system, the CNSC ensures that regulated parties are informed about regular requirements and provides guidance on how to meet requirements while verifying that they are and continue to be met. When doing all of this, the CNSC makes independent, objective, and risk-informed decisions. Now, it is important to mention that this regulatory philosophy aligns with the International Atomic Energy Agency safety fundamentals. Next slide, please. So I'll now hand the presentation over to Bartek Brzezinkowski to give an overview of the Darlington New Nuclear Project and its current status.
Thank you, Peter. So hello, my name is Bartek Brzezinkowski, and I am the project officer leading the licensing review for the Darlington New Nuclear Project. So OPG's Darlington New Nuclear Project is for the construction and operation of up to four new nuclear reactors at the existing Darlington site in the municipality of Clarington. Last month, in October 2022, OPG submitted a license to construct application to construct one small module reactor of up to 300 megawatt electric. In December 2021, OPG selected the GE Hitachi BWRX-300 reactor technology. Next slide, please. So this slide here highlights some of the design features for the BWRX-300 technology, which is the chosen reactor technology for the Darlington New Nuclear Project. CNSC staff have looked at the design features through an optional pre-licensing process where vendors and designers engage with the CNSC under a signed service agreement. This is known as a vendor design review. The review is an opportunity for both the CNSC and the vendor to engage on certain topics where the CNSC provides feedback on the vendor's efforts to address the Canadian regulatory requirements and identifies fundamental barriers to licensing, if any, early in the process. And CNSC staff are able to develop an understanding of the vendor and its design and identify potential regulatory issues. Next slide, please. Now, I'd like to go through a timeline of events for the DNNP project to date. So the environmental assessment for this project began in 2006 when OPG applied for a license to prepare site to build up to four new nuclear reactors at the Darlington site, and an environmental assessment commenced under the Canadian Environmental Assessment Act. In 2009, OPG submitted its environmental impact statement that documented the results of the environmental assessment and revised its license application to the CNSC. In 2012, the Joint Review Panel concluded that the proposed project is not likely to cause significant adverse environmental effects. And taking into account the Joint Review Panel recommendations and mitigation measures, this led to issuing a license to prepare site, which was valid for 10 years until 2022. In 2020, OPG submitted an application to renew the license to prepare site. The following year, in 2021, the license was renewed by the CNSC, which is now valid for another 10 years until 2031. The same year, OPG selected the technology for the project, the GE Hitachi BWRX-300 reactor technology. Next slide, please. So to better understand where the Darlington New Nuclear Project is in the whole CNSC licensing process, here's a visual which depicts the five phases in the life cycle of a nuclear facility. The Class 1 nuclear facility regulations require separate licenses for each of the five phases in the life cycle of a nuclear facility. So that's a license to prepare site, a license to construct, a license to operate, a license to decommission, and a license to abandon. As discussed in previous slide, OPG has been issued a license to prepare site, which is valid until 2031. And most recently, last month, OPG license to construct application was submitted to the CNSC. Next slide, please. We'll now describe the regulatory review process for the Darlington New Nuclear Project. I'll hand the presentation over to Heather Harpel.
Thanks, Bartek. My name is Heather Harpel, and I'm an environmental assessment specialist. OPG's submission will now undergo a technical review. The CNSC's assessment of a license application is a multi-step process as shown in the graphic on this slide. Information submitted in support of an application must demonstrate that the proposed safety and control measures will meet or exceed regulatory requirements and CNSC expectations. As part of the review, CNSC will request expertise from relevant federal departments. For example, those responsible for species at risk, fish and fish habitat, noise, and the transportation of dangerous goods. CNSC may also request expertise from the province and third parties such as academics or international experts. Examples of topics covered in technical assessments include safety analysis, radiation protection programs, detailed decommissioning planning, and operator training programs. If CNSC staff conclude that an application is not complete or satisfactory, the proponent will be asked to submit additional information and/or revise the documents. This technical review process continues until staff are satisfied that all requirements are met. Next slide, please. Here is a list of regulations and regulatory documents that the submission will be assessed against. Just like any other nuclear power plant, small modular reactors are subject to the general nuclear safety and control regulations and Class 1 nuclear facilities regulations. The CNSC has a suite of regulatory documents, also called reg docs, which guide applicants through the licensing process and ensure compliance. These reg docs contain detail on safety principles, objectives, and requirements for compliance. Reg docs also contain guidance on how requirements may be met. Listed here are some key reg docs for this project, which OPG's application will need to address. Reg doc 1.1.2, which provides a license application guideline for the applicant. Reg doc 2.5.2, which sets out a list of design requirements, and Reg Doc 2.3.1, which sets out requirements for the construction and commissioning of facilities in Canada. Next slide, please. Once the application has been assessed, the CNSC will only issue a license when the applicant is deemed qualified to carry on the activity that the license will authorize, has demonstrated that they will protect the health and safety of persons and the environment, has demonstrated that they will maintain national security, has confirmed that they will adhere to international obligations to which Canada has agreed. Next slide, please. OPG submitted a partial license to construct application at the end of last year, which is posted on the OPG website. The submission comprises three work packages of supporting documentation in accordance with the OPG CNSC protocol. The remaining work packages are anticipated in the next 6 months. OPG has also submitted updated documentation to demonstrate how the selected technology fits within the bounds of the environmental assessment that was completed in 2009. The documentation consists of the two reports listed in the middle of this slide. CNSC staff will now review the license application and supporting documentation in the context of the Nuclear Safety and Control Act and the relevant regulations that apply to the activities in the application. Following the technical assessment, CNSC staff provide a commission member document, CMD, with the results of its review and recommendations to the commission. Next slide, please. We'll now provide an overview of Indigenous and public participation for the Darlington New Nuclear Project. For this, I will turn the presentation over to Adam Levine.
Thanks very much, Heather. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Adam Levine, and I'm the team lead for Indigenous consultation and participant funding at the CNSC. So the CNSC is an open and transparent regulator. We are fully committed to engaging the public and Indigenous nations and communities, and utilizing a number of different tools and approaches to ensure that communities and the public have access to information about our technical reviews, our assessment work, our requirements and regulations, and can have their say and get involved in our different regulatory processes, including the review and consultations around the Darlington New Nuclear Project. Next slide. One of these commitments that we're doing for the Darlington New Nuclear Project and other initiatives is using the Open Government Portal. So this is a portal on the web that you can go and access different government documents and data and information. And specifically for the DNNP project, we're gonna be posting a number of different updates and documents, including our information requests and responses from OPG, as well as a number of project milestone updates and other key documents that you can get access to find out what's going on the project and get involved and stay up to date throughout the process. Next slide. There are a number of opportunities coming up for the public and Indigenous nations and communities to get involved in the Darlington New Nuclear Project and the regulatory process, which has already started in October 2022 to spring 2023. We're gonna be focusing on engagement and consultations around two documents that OPG has submitted to us, including the Environmental Impact Statement Report and the Plant Parameter Envelope document, which are gonna be available for public review and comment on our Let's Talk Nuclear platform. We're gonna be holding a workshop as well. And these activities are gonna be supported through our participant funding program. So there's already a participant funding opportunity out there now to support the review of these two documents in participation in upcoming workshops and engagement opportunities. And the deadline for that is December 2nd, 2022. So take a look if you're interested in getting involved in that. And then moving forward, now that Ontario Power Generation has submitted their license to construct application for the DNNP project, we're gonna be kicking off a second phase right away to look at that aspect of it. And there'll be another funding opportunity for that later on, likely this spring or summer 2023. And there's gonna be a number of other opportunities like webinars, more workshops and discussions with the public and directly with interested Indigenous nations and communities on the license to construct application and our technical review. And all that is moving towards eventually, sometime in 2024 or early 2025, we're likely to have a commission proceedings. So commission hearings, where the commission will hear interventions from the public, Indigenous communities, CNSC staff, as well as OPG and other experts regarding the DNNP application, license to construct, and eventually making a decision. So stay tuned for all those opportunities coming up and opportunities to apply for participant funding to support you and your community and your involvement in the process. Next slide. There's also a number of ways to stay up to date and get involved. So here's a number of different links for you to take a look at. And we do have a specific email account for the DNNP project. So if you do have project specific questions, please send us an email. We'll be happy to respond. We also have a subscribers list where you can get up to dates on everything going on at the CNSC. So please subscribe if you're interested. And also there's lots of other information on our social media channels. Now, next slide. So as you can see here, we're all over social media on this front. We have LinkedIn, Facebook, YouTube, et cetera. So we're constantly posting information about the work going on at the CNSC, and we'll be doing specific posts and updates on DNNP. So stay tuned and connected that way. It's a great way to get updated and interact with CNSC staff on this project. So now with that, I encourage you all to get involved and stay tuned for more webinars. And I'll pass back to Sir Eaton for some additional questions and wrapping up the webinar. Thank you.
Thanks so very much. Go ahead.
I'll take it over from here. I think we have the polling question. Sorry, Sarah,
That's fine. We're all excited. Go ahead.
Yeah, no worries. So I just want to, now that ends the presentation portion of the webinar. So I hope you found the presentation helpful. I do want to mention that we will share a PDF copy of the presentation to all registered participants following the MTNR. So as mentioned at the beginning, there are three more polling questions put up on the screen for your consideration. Again, our aim is to continually look at improving our outreach program